Hello and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, hi, my name is Mary and welcome to another Craft Day Wednesday, where every Wednesday I post a new video. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how I made these inspiration block books. That's what they are. This is the front. I painted the front of it. I'm not sure how well you can see that, but I painted the front white to resemble the pages. And then on the back, I just put some letterings on there. And what you're going to need for this project is, depending on what color you wanted to paint, I'm going with gold and black. So I have gold and black paint here, and I have a piece of wood. It's from a 2x4 that I have here. I took it out of my husband's scrap wood because he was just going to throw it away, and I don't throw away nothing in this house. So I found a way to use it, because if you stop and look at it, it actually kind of looks like a book. I mean, so basically what I did was I took this piece of wood here and I went ahead and sent, and I'm gonna show you what I did. So I'm gonna go ahead now and turn my camera down so y'all can see what I'm doing. So we have my camera turned, and basically what I did was I took a piece of sandpaper, and I just basically sand the wood. I've already done it, but I basically just sanded it with the rough edges. And I took my paintbrush, and I'm going to clean my paintbrush off. And I have my container full of black paint. I'm just going to squeeze a little more in. And I just went ahead and painted it black. And this part here that you see here, we're going to paint that white. So that's all I did. I just went ahead and painted this black. And we'll go ahead and do that on camera. And try not to go over the edge much, because we're going to need that part for the pages of your book. And then we're going to go ahead and do the sides. And you're going to end up doing about 2 to 3 coats, depending on how dark you want it to look. And I will be using some sealant to seal the paint in so it doesn't rub off over time, to just protect the paint. So, and just going to lay this down on its side, and just going to take my brush and go down very lightly on the edges, just like that. I'm going to set this one to the side. And I'm going to come in with my other brush, and I'm just going to clean it out. And I'm going to grab my white paint, and we're just going to go in and paint this in, this side white. This is going to be the pages. And if you get a little white on the black like I did, it's no problem, because you could just take your paintbrush and touch that back up again. Because that's what I did. I'm just going to go in and touch it up. Now we're going to do the bottoms. And this paint I got at Dollar Tree, and it dries very fast. So all I'm doing is just going in here, and I'm going to turn this around so I can get this side. And once you get that all dry, I'm going to turn it like this so I can hold it, because I'm going to go over it again. And it's not that wet. It's still kind of damp, but it'll be fine. I'm just going to go back over it anyways because I'm going to put another coat. So sorry about that, y'all. That was my husband sending me a text message. Like I said, sorry, I'm going to go ahead and just go ahead and touch up the edges just like this. And we got all sides painted. Put that in there. I'm going to go back with my black paintbrush because, as y'all can see, I got a spot of white paint there. No problem. Just go over it. Just like I said. And we're going to take our black paint, and we're just going to go in on the edge just like this and touch up your edges. And there you have it. And now I'm going to set this to the side so that can dry. And I've already have two here that I went ahead and did. And to get the gold part on here like I got, I sprayed this one back for a minute. We're going to take painter's tape, and you're just going to put a layer of tape on it. That way, when you paint it, it'll be gold or whichever color you decide you want to go with. So, mine's is all dry, and I'm going to peel the tape off. And then I'm going to peel the tape off here. And your hands are going to get dirty, but that's what soap and water is for. So, we have that one. And if you peel it off and you get some where it looks like this, where it got scuffed up, take your black paint, go back in with it. And then it's going to dry. And we're going to go ahead and peel the tape off of this one. So we have the tape peeled off. We have a little mark here. It's fine. Go in with your black paint. Touch it up. All right. So now that we have our blocks, we're going to pick some inspirational words that we want to use. And for me, I think I'm going to do... faith and courage. So we're going to put faith on one and courage on the other one. And I just got these little sticker letters. I was surprised to find these at Dollar Tree. So I got me some. So we're going to, and to make these stick a little bit better, I'm going to go ahead and go in with some white Elmer's school glue. And I'm just going to put a little bit on my finger once I get it open. So I'm just going to put a little bit on my finger, and we're just going to go ahead, and you're just going to rub this in all the way. Just like this. And we're just going to go ahead and start putting our letters on. So we're just basically spelling out the word faith with our glittery letters. So we have faith. I'm just going to shape this up because it's not... And this will stick down good once you go over it with a little bit of your What is it? Oh, what the word? Your sealer that you're gonna seal the paint in with. You can use whatever you want. So we have faith on this one, and I'm gonna go ahead and put courage on the other one. And we're gonna do the same thing. We're just gonna put a little bit of glue on our finger, and we're just gonna rub that in real good with your fingers. And go ahead and put courage. And we're almost done. Oops, let's pull that off. And E. I'm going to set that out of the way. And this is what we have. We have courage here. So we have faith and we have courage. And I'm going to turn them this way. And you can put, I think I'm going to put it, glue it down this way. So this is the way it's going to look. So I'm going to go ahead and turn it back towards me. And yeah, I want faith on the top and courage on the bottom. So. And then I'm just going to place them how I want it. There we go. And now I'm going to take my hot glue, and you can use wood glue if you want, but I'm going to use hot glue, and we're just going to put some hot glue down on this. And I am going to angle it this way. And I'm just going to put a little bit of pressure to hold that in place. And I'm going to take my black paint, and I'm just going to touch up where I pulled off my tape. So we're going to let that dry. It looks wet on camera, but it's going to dry. Trust me, it's going to dry. And I'm going to take my other paintbrush, and I'm going to dip into my gold paint, and we're just going to touch up right here. And then I'm going to let that dry. But now what we're going to do is we're going to take our letters. Let's grab them in numbers because it's both. And we're going to put, I'm going to put 1 and 2 on here. So we're going to put 1 up here. And I'm going to grab my glue and put a little bit on my finger. And we're going to put some here and we're going to put some here. And we're going to grab our 1. And I'm going to stick that there. And then we're going to take 2 and we're going to put this down here. Gonna stick that on here again, and I'm gonna try to straighten that up, and there we have it. So we have faith and courage in 1 and 2, and it's gonna dry. I see some, yeah, and this is what we have. And like I said, we just started with a scrap piece of wood, and I have 2 more here. And this one is Believe in Yourself. So, yeah. And I'm going to go ahead and turn my camera back up. So, yeah. So, yeah, here is what they look like. faith, believe in yourself, faith, and courage. And we just took scrap piece of wood and made that. And so, yeah, if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. And if you want to see me do any other type of video, or if you just want to ask me some questions, you can do so in the comment box below. I always, always try to answer the questions that y'all ask. You can also ask me on my Twitter or Instagram or Snapchat or wherever you feel like you want. You can even ask them to me on Facebook. But that is it for this video. And if you like it, please give me a thumbs up. And once again, thanks for watching. And I hope y'all all have a good day. Bye.